Chief guest, Sheikh Ahmed Deedat of Islamic Propagation Center International of South Africa, members of his delegation, ulamas, sisters and brothers. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It is indeed a great honor for all of us to have with us tonight Sheikh Ahmed Deedat, a very well-known Muslim scholar. Sheikh Ahmed Deedat does not need any introduction as he is a household name in any Muslim family. Many of us remember his visit to our town in the early 80s. Therefore, he is at home. Before I request Sheikh Ahmed Deedat to talk to us, on behalf of you all, I would like to say thank you very much to all those who were involved in making his stay possible in Mombasa at a very short notice. In particular, we say Asante Sana to Sheikh Sirajur Rahman Nadwi and his associates and the management of Pearl Beach Resort, especially Brother Abdul Rashid and Brother Ayub, for making Sheikh Ahmed Deedat's stay comfortable. My thanks also go to Mr. Rafiq Saliani for providing the public address system and the secretaries and the vice chairman of the Nasapuria Memon Jamaat for the sitting arrangements. Sheikh Deedat shall give his last and final lecture tomorrow, that is Wednesday, 5th of May at Baluchi Mosque after Asr prayer and not at the Islamic Center as earlier announced. After the address by Sheikh Deedat tonight, we shall have a few minutes for question time and God willing, we shall end our program with a dua. Thank you very much and I now request Sheikh Deedat to address us. Thank you very much.
Alhamdulillah wahda wassalatu wassalamu ala man la nabi ba'da Allahumma ya mufattih al-abwab wa ya musabbib al-asbab wa ya dalil al-hairin tawakkaltu alayka ya rabbul alamin wa ufabid amri lillah inna allaha basirun bil-ibad a'udhu billahi min shaytanir rajim bismillahir rahmanir rahim wa qalu لن يدخل الجنة إلا من كان هودا أو نصارى تلك أمانيهم قل هاتوا برهانكم إن كنتم صادقين صدق الله صدق الله العظيم Mr. Chairman and my dear brothers and sisters, I was thinking of what topic to address you tonight. And I thought, for a unique audience like this, the subject will also be unique in this is the first time ever that I am addressing an audience on this topic. The topic is some difficult questions that have been thrown at me during my past 20 years of public speaking. Difficult questions that I have faced. Every night, every lecture is followed by questions. If you ask me, in Nairobi, I had two meetings there. Immediately after my talk, questions. What did they ask you? I can't remember a thing. They asked and I answered. The night before, yes, the people asked me questions and I answered. But there are certain things, questions, 10 years ago the guy asked me and I can't forget. 15 years ago the guy asked me and I can't forget. Now it is that type of question I'm going to share with you tonight. Some difficult questions that I had to face. But beginning at the beginning, how did I get started in this field of activity? Soon after leaving school, I started working in a country shop, somewhere out of the city of Durban, about 25 miles out. There was a Muslim shop. And across the valley from the shop was a Christian mission. So these missionaries, that they were getting their training, how to do jihad, the crusades against the Muslims, whatever they learned, they came to practice on the Muslims in the shop. All young men just left school. Cheap labor. They would come into the shop to buy sugar and salt, flour, rice. But when they came to do their purchases, they would start with as, he says, you know, your Prophet Muhammad had so many wives. And I knew nothing about that. About the wives of the Prophet, our mothers, I knew nothing about that. They would say that your Prophet Muhammad, he spread his religion at the point of the sword. He forced Islam down people's throats, that if you don't accept Islam, I'll chop off your head. That's how he got the converts. I knew nothing about that. They say that the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he copied his book, the Qur'an, from the Jews and the Christians. This is the copy, imitation of the Christian Bible. I knew nothing about that. The only thing I knew about Islam was that I was a Muslim. And I read the Shahada, the Kalima. If I met any of you during that period, in my teens, then if I ask you where you come from, you say Kenya. I say, what you? Then what religion you belong to? You say, you're a Muslim. I say, read the Shahada. So if you could say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, I say, pass. You pass. But what that meant, I didn't know. It was like a magic formula. If you can say it, you're a Muslim. If you can't say, you're not a Muslim. That's all I knew. Can you say Shahada? So yes, say it. I hear it, I say, right, you pass. I prayed the way my father prayed. I made song, fasting the way my father fasted. I made wudu the way my father did. Everything. I was a Muslim, read the Shahada, and led an ordinary Muslim life. What these Christians are posing to me, I knew nothing.